Hi, HSPs. I hope you're doing well. I'm going live again and pop on and click like or love if you're here. I'd love to hear from you. We're going to talk about sensory overload today. A lot of us as HSPs don't always recognize when we are having sensory overload and what that might look like, some symptoms of that. To introduce myself, in case this is one of the first times you're seeing my video, I'm Julie Bjelland, and I am a psychotherapist and HSP global consultant and an author. So I've written a bunch of books for the highly sensitive person. I also have a wonderful online course for sensitive for HSPs, and we have a lot of fun in our course, and it's an 8-week program. So anyway, let's talk about sensory overload. If any of you are on right now, why don't you put into the comments what you think sensory overload might feel like to you. And a previous blog post that I did about this came up, and I took a kind of a poll about it, and several people had quite a few things to say. That and I'll read some of them to see if you guys relate to any of them to sensory overload. Because a lot of people don't always recognize that sensory overload, what it might feel like. So if you're feeling really irritable, you might think that you have an anger problem. I've heard that from HSPs before. They come to me and say, I think I have an anger problem. But in fact, they're actually just sensory overloaded. Things like, if you're in the kitchen, you're cooking and the kids are running in and out and there's a TV on and the fan's on over the stove and there's a bunch of noise, that can be sensory overload. And think about what that feels like, in your body and to recognize what that is. And I could even think about times when maybe I went to a restaurant and it was a busy restaurant, and if we were sitting in the center of the restaurant, the noise from all the way around me could cause sensory overload. And before I understood about the trait, I would often feel very irritable and not understand why I felt that way, just on the edge. And so it was really great to learn about sensory overload. That's something we talk about in my 8-week program as well, because it's important to identify and do things for to make it better. So if you're here, click like. Love to know that you guys are here. It's really fun to be able to connect with you guys. So hopefully you'll pop on and say hi. Where are you guys from? I'm from California, but I do global work all over. So that's what I love, to working with you HSPs all over the world. So let me read some things that you guys had to say about what sensory overload feels like. Some people said it feels like out of control, trapped in a burning building, electricity and light pulsating through your body, pure exhaustion, chaos, things like there's too much coming at you from everywhere, sights, sounds, smells, actions, people, thoughts, pressure. Start wanting to shut down, go numb and blank, need to get away to quiet and peace. I want to make a point that when we get that feeling like you just need to get away, I remember having that feeling when I would be overloaded, like I might need to flee. That's part of that overactivation of the amygdala that we experience as HSPs, where your brain is actually going into a space of fight, flight, freeze. Because it's interpreting what you're experiencing as danger. So the body sets you up as if you have to fight or flee. And that's why we get the tight muscles, the short, shallow breaths, all of that, and the racing heart. Those are all signals that your body sent adrenaline and stress hormones to prep you for fighting or fleeing. So what's important to do as an HSP is to learn how to reset the system. And there's a way to do that. There's a way to set the brain, to reset the brain, because the brain believes you're in danger, and that's why it sends out kind of those alarm bells going off in your body. And there's particular techniques you can do that actually change that. I just find that incredibly amazing because I know most of the HSPs I've worked with globally, as and myself included, we often, before we do this kind of brain training, experience this on a daily basis. And can we just imagine the impact on our overall well-being, having the alarm center of our brain go off every day? It's really difficult, and that's where we're going to see a lot of chronic conditions pop up, and most of the students and clients I work with are able to actually reduce all of that. And I just find it amazing that we can literally train the brain, and it works. I've done it with thousands of HSPs globally. It's something that changed my life as a highly sensitive person. I'm on the way up on the scale of 27 out of 27, and it changes everything. Your energy levels, you sleep better, you're not on edge, you feel like you have space to, you know, have patience and be extra, have extra energy for your family, as an example. Oh, good. We got some people popping on to say hi. Santi, I hope I'm saying that right, from South Africa. How wonderful. Hi. Nice to see you. And Don, you think that makes sense? Yeah. You guys experience some sensory overload? What are some of your symptoms that you might have? I'll read some more to you guys. Chaos, like an out-of-body experience where I'm watching my life fall apart and I have no control to stop it. Some people said my bed or small room is the only way to feel somewhat safe. Isolating is protection for me. I remember being like that before I did my brain training. It was really difficult. All I could think about was getting back into my room and into a safe space and away from what felt like just so much chaos going on in life. And the more that we do the brain training to, I mean, how amazing is that, that we can literally train the brain to think, to know that we're not in danger anymore, that we're safe. And we have to train our brain to recognize the difference between a perceived threat and a real threat, because the brain responds as if it's a real threat, because it doesn't know the difference unless you do some of these techniques that help. People say it feels like I can't think straight, my mind reels, a kind of slow panic, feeling like I need to escape as quickly as possible. Again, there's another escape one, and they're talking about they can't think straight. Another part of the reason for that is because when we've activated that part of our brain that believes that there's, you know, danger, and danger can come in the form of somebody can criticize us and our brain can go into a place of feeling like we're in danger. We can make a mistake, and because HSPs don't like to make mistakes, we like to get things right the first time. These are things that can make our brain actually feel like we're not safe. And that's part of what sends that alarm bell out. So when the alarm bell gets sent out like that in the brain and the signals get sent, then your cognitive thinking brain is kind of going to go to sleep. And that's what happens. That's why we feel in a daze, foggy, we lose memory, we can't think straight, all of that, because your cognitive brain is what supports your emotional brain. And so my 8-week online course program, we train our brain in that 8 weeks to recognize the difference between a real threat and a perceived threat. And it's so neat because within 2 to 3 weeks, people start growing new neural sprouts where they already recognize that, wow, you know, my brain is not sending those signals like it used to every day. So that's really helpful. Hi, guys. I love that you're here. And click like and love if you're here. I love to see those little hearts pop up as we're talking. That's always something that feels good. Sherry, hi. You need this help badly. Yeah, I totally understand it. It's why I created my course. You could check out, it's hspcourse.com. And I actually work with you guys through this course throughout the 8 weeks. And by the time you get through the 8 weeks, you've grown new neural sprouts. So you can start to change the reaction that the brain's having. I mean, it's completely life-changing, and it is part of really being able to thrive as a sensitive person. And we have to do that. We live in a really, you know, unless you're living out on land and you hardly see people and it's quiet and you don't have to go to work or be in a commute, If you're in today's modern world as a sensitive person, especially if your numbers are really high up into the high 20s, it's really difficult. Most of us need to do this kind of brain training to be well, to be balanced. Yeah, Sherry, you said, I hardly ever go out anymore. It's so bad. Brain fog, taking on other folks' pain and emotions. Yep, I get it. I used to be like that too. That was my life. And until I reached a point that I just couldn't do that anymore. And that's when I started learning about the brain and specializing in this trait. And the more I worked with people globally, I realized that so many of us have such a similar experience, and we have real brain differences in this trait that they found through research that makes us more susceptible to this, to these really high stress levels. And, you know, this trait is called sensory processing sensitivity. It's not a disorder, but it's a sensory processing sensitivity. So many of us have a more sensitive experience with the five senses, if you think about it like that. Sometimes people have it more with one sense over another, like noise, or as an example, can be something that is more difficult for some people. Hi, Dawn. You always need to face the door and have to see what's going on. Yeah, that's part of that prepping part, that I need to stay vigilant. I need to stay alert. I always have to be on top of everything. I mean, if you think about what's happening in the body when we're constantly on alert like that, and some people, it'll show up with OCD symptoms, different kinds of high anxiety issues, chronic issues. I think one of you said that about chronic pain. Yes, absolutely, Sherry. Chronic pain can definitely be worsened when this part of our brain is constantly activated. And so most people see a reduction in pain as well, because if you think about, we're constantly setting off the signals in our brain and having those stress hormones and chemicals go flooding into the body, that is going to cause a lot of long-term damage. And people that have this happening all over and over again, it causes damage. But luckily, we can reverse some of the damage, and we can actually get to a point where we feel so much healthier. So tell me where you're from, and click like or love if you're here. I love to see that. What else have we got? Rama, hopefully I'm saying that, from Dubai. Oh, lovely, you're a teacher. My energy is always drained and my body feels heavy. My diet's bad and I love coffee. I think I need to lose weight, but I binge. I have anxiety, irrational fear that I wish can end. Yes, I'm so sorry you're experiencing that. A lot of HSPs talk about these same symptoms, and it's a cycle. Like maybe we can't sleep, so we have more coffee, and then the coffee causes effects with caffeine that can impact our sensitive systems. You talked about anxiety and irrational fear. The irrational fear and the anxiety does come from that emotional brain. It comes from the fact that that emotional brain is too activated and the cognitive brain is gone to sleep. So it's not there to support the emotional brain. I used to experience that every day. I totally understand what that feels like, and it is awful. It's such an awful feeling. I used to have chronic migraines and stomach issues and all kinds of stuff, as do many HSPs. But as soon as we start to do some of this brain training, like I do in my 8-week program, we shift that. And, you know, if you're not sending out the signals of having your body having to process all those stress hormones and adrenaline, then your body is going to be healthier in general. It's really shocking what a difference it makes when you do some of this brain training. It does get better, and that is my message to you guys. I would not be able to do what I'm doing as a 27 out of 27 if I had not done my own brain training. There's no way I could do what I'm doing, but now I'm able to help people, and my work and research about this trait is making an impact, and that is so important to me to get you guys these tools. Yeah, Santi says, overwhelmed, like life is falling apart, and then you're paralyzed, doing even less, and then feeling even worse. Yep, I get it. Everything is really hard to do when your emotional brain is too activated. So it's important to learn these techniques. This is an investment in your whole life. The amazing thing about this program that I work with my students, my HSP students in, is that it changes your life forever. I mean, once you develop these tools and you learn how to train your brain as an HSP not to be so reactionary and to be more centered and balanced, and to not send out those stress signals every day, you get to keep those tools. They stay with you. And I love watching, like, so many of my students in my HSP course, they're like out there flying. I've seen some of them go out and start their own courses, start their own businesses, go from a place of being, having a hard time, really struggling in survival mode, to actually going out and making a difference in the world. And I know that that is what happens when we do this kind of training. And that's my goal, is to get you guys out there making a difference in the world, because HSPs are the most compassionate, empathetic, intuitive people out there, very creative, very intelligent. Your brain is a supercomputer brain, but nobody taught us how to manage that supercomputer brain. Nobody taught me how to do it either, so I had to teach myself, and that is how I go out and teach you guys now. Sherry says, forget which day it is, floaty feeling when awake, feels if I tried to jump, I would leave my body. Yeah, that's all from that emotional brain activation when the cognitive brain has gone to sleep. I remember those feelings as well. I can remember being in a store one time and completely forgetting my password or my PIN number from my debit card, and I had a whole bunch of groceries, and it was just awful. And that's part of what happens, is we lose access to our memory even, and rational thought. That's why I'm sure most of you have experienced that feeling of you can't think straight, and maybe you're even arguing with someone, and then you realize later that, after you've calmed down, like, oh wow, okay, I understand what happened now. And maybe you feel bad, shame. That's a cycle that comes up a lot, a shame cycle, if we've had a reaction or we started a fight or maybe we've cried in a meeting at work or something. Maybe we've snapped at our kids. Something that doesn't make us feel good, and it turns into a cycle. And so my goal with this class is to change that cycle for you guys, because it works. And it's so important to invest in yourself like this. Think about the people that will benefit in your life if you are feeling better. You're worth it, and we need you out there really thriving in the world. Yeah, Sherry, I live in a town, population of 750. Oh, I used to live in a small town too. And you also live in Michigan, Upper Pennsylvania. So whenever I can, I go to the beach at Lake Michigan alone with my dogs, and we go for a walk in the woods. Oh, love it. Self-care is so incredibly important. Good for you. That is really important, and it changes everything. And we need to learn, that's something we talk about in my course too, is what is real self-care for an HSP, what actually works, because sometimes we're doing stuff that the 80% are doing, and that doesn't work for us. So we need to do what works for us to get true restoration. That's what we're looking at. Oh yeah, you take care of your elderly dad too. Oh, being a caretaker is incredibly exhausting for an HSP, and I know a lot of you out there are doing that. And even more so, the reason why you need to take care of your own needs, and even more self-care than the average person if you're a caretaker. And you said, I sleep and I'm very tired all the time. Yep, that's it. That's if your body has to process all that adrenaline and stress hormones when that's happening. And it is exhausting. It's fatiguing. I used to be tired all the time. I can remember when I was young, my mom used to think there was something wrong with me because I was always tired, and my energy was so bad. And if I stayed two nights in a row with a friend, I would get sick. It was really difficult, and we didn't know about the trait back then or what to do about it. So this is why I'm so passionate about giving you guys this information, because it gets so much better with the right training. So you can see on my hspcourse.com page, read about what other HSPs have experienced. I have a whole page of testimonials on there from HSPs that have taken the course and their lives have changed. So I recommend you guys read that, because this is an investment in you. And if you're, who's gonna, and you know, who's gonna do it if you don't do it. It's up to us to make this better for ourselves. And this is a long-term investment in your health and well-being, and it's really important. Okay, looking at some more parts. Yeah. Yeah, you're arguing with you. Yep. And then you feel bad. Yep, I get it. That's the thing that's so hard too, is I can remember that. I used to have meltdowns all over the place before I did my own brain training. And it just gets so much better. And I want you guys to know that it really does get so much better with the right tools. So if some of you are interested in joining me in the 8-week program, I would love to talk with you and work with you and support you through that 8 weeks, because that's what's going to happen. You're going to grow these new neural sprouts just working through the program together. And I support you all the way through it. And then afterwards, you get to join a wonderful group of graduates, HSP graduates, and they're so loving and kind, and it's a wonderful group of people. I know a lot of HSPs say that they wish that they could have some HSP friends, and you know, this here's an opportunity to have something like that long term, and an example of trying something together, you know. So I hope that was helpful for you guys. I also have a blog I really invite you to subscribe to. My heart goes into writing a weekly blog for you guys all about the trait. My whole life is about teaching people across the globe about the trait. And the cool thing about the course is you can be in your pajamas and you can be at home, and it's great for, you know, anybody. You can do it at your own pace, and then we meet together weekly through a video, something like this, although some people prefer to do audio, and that's okay too. So whatever works for you, and it's important to have the right tools so that you can get better. Let's train our brains, and let's be those people, those HSPs in the world that are out there thriving, because it gets so much better. Thanks for being here, guys. I love reading all your comments, and I hope to see some of you join me in the course. I would love to work with you. And, you know, there's a point at which people reach where they just decide that how it is just cannot continue like that, and they need to make changes. Or maybe you want to accomplish something that you haven't been able to accomplish, whether it's in your job, career, family, relationship, any of that, because all of those things get better when we are in our alignment, in our center, in our balance, and in our living our authentic life. So I hope that for you. Thank you. Oh, Sherry, love you too. thanks for being here, guys. I am going to go join my course now and talk to my students, and I'm really looking forward to working with them on their journey. So we're going to do that now, and I hope you guys come over and join. Check it out, hspcourse.com. Love to have you. You guys take good care of yourselves. Remember, this is an investment in your life. Whatever you end up doing, whether it's exploring my website and all the resources there, or joining me to work with me directly, I would love to help you get better and live your best life. You are very welcome. Thanks for being here, guys. You take good care of yourselves until we meet again. Okay, bye-bye.